Lagos, a city of 21 million people with acute water shortages. Less than 10% of Lagos residents have access to clean public water. Infrastructure at the city's water utility is comatose.
If you want to go wash, now what are you going to use? If you want cook soup, now what are you going to
use? The situation of water in Epe is very tough. We are having like three water corporations in Epe, and it's not working fine.
After several failed loans from the World Bank, the Lagos State Government in 2004 established the Lagos State Water Regulatory Commission and the Lagos State Water Corporation to create the environment for water privatization or private-public partnership. By 2014, the state government went into an advisory contract with the International Finance Corporation. The contract is to fast-track the process of privatizing the Lagos water infrastructure. But water rights activists fought back. The people fought back. The water rights activists began a large-scale organizing. The Our Water, Our Right movement was born.
In 2015, when we got the information that the Lagos State government was going to an advisory contract with IFC, basically on how to privatize the Lagos water, we knew that we have problems in our hands. And because we are very convinced that the wave of the privatization of the public service is anti-people and negates all the principles of human rights, particularly as regards to water. And so we felt that the best way to do is to organize. And we started organizing our people. Our water rights movement, you know, was born.
I believe that for a management to come up, I said the only way to go in managing water facility in Lagos is for them to hand it over to private individuals. I see that firstly as self-indictment. Again, there are lots of money in between 1999 and now. There are lots of money, you know, that has gone into water sector. But unfortunately, the amount of money that has got into water sector, we do not see, you know, evidence that this money actually used for the purpose it was meant for at the initial stage.
The movement since 2015 has pushed back efforts by the Lagos State Government in conjunction with the World Bank and global water multinationals like Vaola and Abengoa.
The evil that will come upon us, because we are all Lagos citizens, is that one, we are not going to have better water quality. First of all, the investment will not, these corporations are not going to put in a dime. Public-private partnerships, as we know, is just another word for scam. These investors are not going to bring any money. It is still the state government, that Lagos state government, that will take them to the bank and secure loans for them. And if they default, it is still Lagos that is going to pay.
There were rallies, community meetings, petitions, and even consultations with government. All these activities made the environment toxic for water privatization. But the promoters of water privatization won't back down easily. In 2017, the Lagos State Government introduced the controversial anti-people Lagos environmental law through which they hid the privatization agenda. The law, among others, criminalizes the entire informal water sector. But the Our Water, Our Right movement rose to the occasion. The people won.
There are critical points along the road. When we started in 2015, the government went outside Nigeria to boast that they were going to conclude privatization or PPP within 4 months. Here are we, 2019. None of those contracts have succeeded. We have slowed down the hands of water privatization in Lagos and in Nigeria. Well, we will continue to mobilize the people to say water is a right. We will continue to mobilize Lagosians to demand democratic control of public water. We have produced a document to show them alternative to what the World Bank and the IFC is proposing to them. We will ensure that we win definitely in Lagos.
Till date, the Our Water, Our Right has pushed back governors and still winning. The Our Water, Our Right coalition remain resolute on winning since they believe a win in Lagos will resonate across Nigeria and Africa and send a strong signal to water privatizers to keep their hands off water.